what makes a successful musician? If you asked me that when I was 17, I would say, that's easy. Successful musicians are rich and famous. Lots of money, MTV cribs, giant arenas full of screaming fans, a million chicks. Those movies that we saw. The Song Remains the Same, Some Kind of Monster, The Beatles Anthology. See, all of those movies show musicians at that staggeringly high level of fame, the pinnacle of fame. I guess if you ask the typical person who wasn't a musician, they would give you the sort of same answer. What does success mean? It means having everything. But 99.9% of all musicians, me included, will never ever reach that high exalted position. Most musicians will never even know what it's like to get a record deal. Let's examine this question. What makes for a successful musician and how is that success measured? Here we go. I've been doing music since I was 17 and I can fully remember all the bits and pieces of the crazy journey. All the way from the time that I bought my first microphone from that local music store at the mall, all the way up to now. See, before I ever got into a band and started playing in bands, my first experience as a musician was probably like everyone else, singing to records. Or should I say, trying to sing to records. Trying to emulate the singers that I loved. I tried to sing The Rover by Led Zeppelin. No way, couldn't do it. Tried to sing Baba O'Reilly by The Who. Couldn't even come close. Gates of Babylon by Rainbow, Stargazer, forget about it. The neighbors hated me, for eternity, from day one, as I slowly embraced the gentle art of screeching. That's what it was, you know. It certainly wasn't singing. Some have likened it to the sound of a cat caught in the clothes dryer. Can You See the Real Me, Houses of the Holy, Trampled Underfoot, The Wanton Song. Oh, I especially butchered that one. It was a long, long road to be able to sing something as difficult as Blackout in the Red Room or Come on, Feel the Noise. You know, I wish I could say that I was born with huge talent, but alas, no way. So it begins, the journey. Success at first was measured by being able to sing a bunch of the songs that you loved and not blowing your voice out. Being able to struggle your way through the Physical Graffiti record without tearing your voice to shreds. That was something that could be called a success. Just doing that was successful. When you're in your first band, you start out by playing backyard parties. At least I did in the San Fernando Valley. Playing the UFO songs like Lights Out and Rock Bottom for all the Jeff Spicoli kids in the neighborhood. Success back then could be measured by how many people you could fit into a backyard. You actually made money by charging people at the gate. $2 a head, chicks free. Remember those kegger parties? If the backyard was full, it was a success. You made 30, 40 bucks. You might even get laid out of it. Another success. Think of it, you're actually emulating what your famous rock star idols have done, albeit on this microscopic scale, like 1/100,000th of a Led Zeppelin gig. Success being measured then in tiny increments, tiny little life morsels of fame, fortune, and glory. Then you started to write songs. You started to play your own songs live. Another kind of success. Now you're not just singing Paranoid or Cat Scratch Fever, you're singing songs that you wrote. Think about that. A teenager, not yet a man, putting words down on paper and singing them to people, and you gotta look them in the eye when you're doing it. Think about how ballsy that was. Will they like it? Will they think I suck? Do I suck? So many variables. Pretty soon after, you're at Gazzari's. You're actually playing Gazzari's on the Sunset Strip. You're hanging out at the Troubadour, watching bands like Rat, Dubrow, who became Quiet Riot, Dokken, White Sister, Steeler, and now it's your turn. Playing a club on the Strip, that was a success. Just getting to that place and playing those hallowed halls where all the greatest bands have played, that was a success. playing the Whiskey a Go-Go for the first time and imagining that the Doors and Led Zeppelin have played right where you're standing. Unreal. Unreal. Your first gigs, totally empty. No one cared. No one was interested in your little rock band, but you persisted. And one day, years later, hundreds of gigs later, you actually started to get a following on the Strip, an actual following, the hardest, most competitive place in the world, and you're an actual contender. Guns N' Roses, LA Guns, Faster Pussycat are all your peers. They set the bar for rock, and you're right there with them. In 1987, you're playing at the Whiskey with a then unknown Guns N' Roses. That in itself could be called success. Unbelievable. Then you get the record deal. Wow, you can't believe it. You're signed. You made it. Success. Or so you thought. Now you got to make the record, and it's got to be a good record. Now you have to tour incessantly. Now you got to make a video and hope it gets on MTV. Yes, my brother, you're in the big leagues now, but for all intent and purpose, you're a f***ing rookie. That's it. The initial success of signing the record deal was amazing, but that moment was fleeting. People look at you and they envy you. They envy your band. They wish they had a record deal. But see, they will never feel this kind of pressure. Now you actually have to sell records to stay afloat. Product. Product. Success is now measured in things called units, like a spreadsheet. Records are units, and your hopes and dreams are measured in little dots and dashes on some Columbia Records ledger. Now being successful means you have to sell millions and millions of records. And for your band, that just didn't happen. So the record company let you go. What happened? Well, what happened? You've achieved what so many have dreamed of. You've toured with and you've befriended so many of your rock star idols. You've been on MTV. You've done amazing business in the UK. In the UK, you're kind of famous. But the well has run dry. This particular string of luck has run out. So what do? Retire? Jump off a bridge? Or do you just keep going? Now we come full circle. Now you're a hired gun, and success is measured again, only totally different. No more MTV, no more Song Remains the Same. Now success is measured by you being able to pay your rent with music, paying for your car, this brand new Toyota RAV4, your car insurance with music, being able to take a girl out on a date and buy her a nice dinner because you play music. Success now is not being a leech. Success is paying your own way. Wow, that is success. Now you're doing what the rest of the world has to do, earn a living, the only difference being most people hate what they do and you love it, which in my mind makes me a success. See, my definition of success has changed over the years. It's been adapted by time, modified by circumstance. Chicks and glory and free beer, that shit is over. Now it's sink or swim, depending on how good you are and how reliable you are. And of course, if you're still able to hit those high notes every night. See, a lot of your peers can get away with sucking or resorting to the cheating of using tracks, but you can't do that. You have to be good every single night or the rock vultures will start circling. So success, what does it mean? You have to look at success and what it means through the prism of art and commerce. If you suck and you can't sing, you're gone. If your band can't fill up a room, you won't get booked. If you can't work, you can't make a living, and so on. What makes a successful musician is pragmatism and drive and sobriety and assertiveness. It's not letting people take advantage of you. It's learning from your 1,001 mistakes. Success is a homegrown confidence not easily explained to the uninitiated. The kind of people who think that stupid rock star movie is real, because it's not. Gimme Shelter. Now that movie was real. Behind the Music, that's real. Seeing people fall by the wayside, that's real. So you do the best you can, and you fly right, and you don't let life f*** you over. It's your old pal, Jizzo, rocking and rolling. We'll see you next time.